We want everybody to be able to see our lives and see what God's done in our lives to bring us to this point. It's not that just one day we decided to be married, but there's a process of God working in both of our lives and our hearts to make us the people that we are today. And Tanya and I decided that we wanted you to participate not only in our service today, but participate in what God's done in our lives and celebrate with us and look at your own lives and be able to see how to get to know God closer and experience His power and His presence in your life.
My father, earthly father, who's going to be marrying me today, one day was preaching, and I was 8 years old, and I can actually remember sitting there listening to a sermon when usually I would scribble and write stuff down or whatever on my own. But he shared his testimony in his message one day about how he came to know the Lord as his personal Lord and Savior, and how he accepted Jesus and knew that he was a sinner and was not going to heaven because of that sin, because it separated him from God.
Until I was about 20 years old, my second year of college, after searching and trying to figure out what I wanted to do in life, there began to be some people in my life that took some time to care, to want to hang out with me, wanted to get to know me. One of those was my brother Scott and a guy at college named Sammy. And they began to be very special to me, began to take time to talk to me about God and knowing God.
And after the service, when my family, we were driving home in the car, I just couldn't get what my dad had said to me out of my head. So while everybody in my family went inside to the grocery store to get lunch for the day or whatever, I just stayed in the car and I prayed and asked Jesus to be my Lord and Savior.
I thought I was pretty much okay because I knew who God was. I thought I had an idea and understanding, as we all kind of have our own understanding who we think God is. But the understanding I had was created by myself. It was what I wanted God to be. And these guys took time to sit down and share with me and talk to me about who God really was and how God revealed Himself to us through the Bible. And they walked me through the Bible to show me that I could know God in a personal way.
So I went away to Carson Newman College in Jefferson City, Tennessee, which is a long way from home to a beach bum like me.
There's about a 2-week time period in November of 95 when God was just changing my life and getting my attention. He was showing me so many things through the preaching of the Word by my pastor, Brother Russ, at Wildwood Baptist Church, through this guy, Sammy, sharing with me at school, and through my brother, Scott, inviting me to go to church with him. God just really got hold of my heart and showed me that I was longing for this relationship with Him. And it all began with putting my faith and trust in His Son, Jesus.
And then I met a wonderful, godly man who I got to meet and married in 96. And his name was Raymond Worsham, who is now with, I believe, because of the promises and that are told in the Bible and what Jesus promised to us, and He's never broken a promise. Yeah, I believe He's with Jesus right now, and I'm grateful for knowing that. And,
shortly after that, within about a year after my new commitment to the Lord, God called me to serve Him with my entire life. And I began to work at the church, working with students and student ministry, preaching the gospel. He gave me a great desire to tell people about what God did in my life and how He could do it for them as well.
I had a good couple of years being able to be married to Him, and we'll never forget it. And after He died, God just really did a number on me because I wanted to go home, do nothing, well, or at least hang out with my parents, and just thought I was going to help them with stuff, which would have been a good thing. But I was afraid to do what I knew God was telling me to do, which was to go back to do apartment ministry in Raleigh and finish school at Southeastern Seminary.
He called me to go to seminary. I wasn't sure why. I wanted to stay where I was at. I was comfortable. Everything was going good. I had a great job. I had some great friends, some great relationships. But God was challenging me to go outside that. And He was calling me to go to Southeastern Seminary. I didn't know why. I thought it was just to get an education. But as we all find out here today, it's much more than that.
God had given, I think, a vision to Sean and myself to try to do a tent revival in our community because we really wanted our community to be able to come and know Jesus. And this was a unique way of being able to tell people about the Lord. And we had put this whole thing together with the help of Forest Hills Baptist Church and asked one of our evangelism professors if he would be willing to speak at this event, and he couldn't do it, and so he recommended one of the students.
And I got invited and asked to do a tent revival. And I was just excited to have an opportunity to be able to preach and to share the gospel with people. And I met Tanya and Sean, and they began to tell me about what God was doing in this community, in this neighborhood. So I agreed to go, and I was just looking at an opportunity to preach and an opportunity to tell people about Jesus.
God used that tent revival in many ways. First of all, being that he was able to use it to share his message of salvation, of his sacrifice for our sins, how he used Jesus for that, and that was presented very clearly and lovingly to the people at Cameron Gardens.
We began to go door to door and talk to people about Jesus. And as we did that, I remember one case, we were talking to a lady, we're trying to explain to her what sin was. And we're trying to be very clear and explain to her that sin was anything we did to be a disobedient to God. And in that process, as we were sharing the gospel with her, something inside my heart just got hold of me. And it was almost as if Tanya and I were a team sharing the gospel with this lady, that we were put there together by God to do that.
He would share, and I would just sit there with my mouth wide open and hearing him talk about Jesus to these people, just in awe and wanting to hear more of him. And I was like, I want to be around somebody like this who can share Jesus this clearly and effectively to people.
And it's from that moment on that I knew that God had placed Tanya in my life for much more than just a friend, much more than somebody to do ministry with. I knew that God had prepared me and her for that time in our life to be together and to get married and to serve him with the rest of our lives.
And the reason we wanted to do a video was so we wanted everyone to know who is most important in our life and who we want to devote our lives to. No matter what happens to both Andy and I, our main goal and objective for the rest of our lives is to serve the Lord no matter what it brings, and that the marriage vows are very sacred and very important, that through the good and the bad, we're going to stick together. And it's very important to me that I have someone like him who puts God first. And I just pray that if you don't have that, you find that someday in somebody. And if you do have that already, that you renew your vows with us today.
And we believe, just like you putting God first in your life, by us putting God first in our marriage, that it's going to work, and we're going to be able to honor and glorify him in all we do.
Jesus, I am so blessed.